What it do, Way family? It's your girl RG3 live from the 313. Coming to y'all with S7 Part 2 review. Coming at y'all with the Wave Enforcer. 544 and 552 review. Coming at y'all with connection tips today. I'm just coming at y'all. So let's get this thing popping. So let's start with this S7 review. Shout out to my boy Mario Charvet on Facebook. MarioSharvage. He got a bomb product called S7. What it looks like. I did part one on my YouTube. This is part two. About to show y'all what it's looking like. Like I said in part one, I like to use S7 as a finisher after I'm done with everything, you feel me? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run through my session with my Wave Enforcer 552 and 544. So let's make this clear. This is not my first Wave Enforcer brush. I had bought 09. I bought this a boy from 09. This boy old. And I had another 544. My little brother used it for a dog shampoo brush, and he ended up fucking it up. So I never really got to use it. So this is technically an OG, and it's a new school 544. So, from what I got from it is that the bore bristle was a little bit different, and the OG was a little bit wider. But other than that, that's it. So, here we go. The 544 is a hard medium, in my opinion. It really lifts your hair. I call it the depth brush. For those out there seeking depth, make this your friend throughout the day. I'm going to use it on the regular for depth. I personally don't think I'm ready for it yet. I'm going to give it another week before I really start using it. I just got a 3 against the grain. Maybe a week and a half ago. Week ago. So, it's really pulling in my sides pretty good. I'm trying to get lower down in here, so I'm working on that. And my weak spot right here. So I've been beating it with this. What I would do is keep a good 5-10 minute session with this. Finish him off with this. But see, what I'm going to do for y'all right now is that I'm going to hit my head real quick with the 544 all over. Just for y'all, I'm going to do this real quick. Then I'm going to add in an S7 for y'all. Let y'all know how I usually finish my session. So, grab my S7 with this. Unless you want the stuff, you don't need a lot. So you use about that much. You probably don't need that much. Put some back. I like that much. Poof. Apply it. Try to put it on evenly. When you're rubbing it in, you automatically feel your hair getting softer. No lie. No BS. So it's already softer like this. Just rubbing it in. Make sure you have it in good. Right now, I know my camera quality is low, but you don't really see no stick ups, do you? Nope, pretty cool, right? So,
happiness here.
My bad, that's my song. So, I used to hit the S7 with a softy, but I hit it with the 552. Now, the 552 is a soft, in my opinion, a soft medium. But to me, it's a good finisher brush. It don't disturb your pattern. It's got a little firmness to it. Pushing in the S7, help with my lay once I rag. See my weak spot, forked up right there. So this S7, when I was using it, helped push me to a 10-week wolf. This result of 10 weeks wolfing, 3 against the grain, I'm a weak end. So, just a quick session for y'all. Only downfall about the 552 is that the paddle, this little small area you get to brush with. But if you got an established pattern and you brush consistently, consistent angles, you ain't got nothing to worry about. I like how it lays your hair. Both brushes, back in 09, these wave enforcer brushes was $1.97. Now they done went up to almost $3, $2.50. So, they're cheap, highly effective. I do recommend both wave enforcer 544 and 552. It's your girl, RG3. Team Cold Label, Team Spring. That's 7. Over and out.